Hey guys, welcome back to Hike Oregon. This is part 3 of Pandemic Hiking 101. In today's video, I'm gonna go over some of the comments, questions, and concerns from you guys about this whole COVID situation, and also comment on some situations that you guys have been seeing recently in the outdoor space. I apologize if the lighting is a little back and forth. It is partly sunny here today, which makes it incredibly hard to film. One minute it's sunshine through my window, the next minute the sun is behind clouds. I apologize if that's a little distracting. Okay, let's start with Jill and Todd from Facebook. They said, "My only concern is when will they open camping and hiking back up? Camping with your family, those living in your house, is a great way to spend quality time while social distancing from others. I just don't get why it's closed." The reason they closed campgrounds and state parks and the developed trailheads — by developed trailheads, they mean trailheads with bathrooms, boat ramps, picnic tables, those kinds of things. So the reason they closed those, it makes sense. The reason they closed them was because obviously people go there and touch surfaces that the Forest Service cannot clean on an hourly or even on a daily basis. So they just went ahead and closed those areas off completely. That was their concern. It's a big concern for me as well, especially as we get further into late spring and early summer. I understand it had to happen for, what, the last 2 months. However, I feel like at this point, we can start to reopen things slowly instead of just leaving it shut down for the foreseeable future, as far as our state parks just announced it is closed until the foreseeable future. That's a huge concern for me, mostly because of fire danger. People are still gonna go camp. Just because you closed campgrounds doesn't mean people are gonna be like, okay, well, I guess I can't camp. No, people are gonna go camp anyway, and a lot of people don't have experience with dispersed camping, and that is gonna be really dangerous for when things get dry, as fire danger goes up. People are still gonna make fires. That's what people love. People always complain when the fire danger is high and you aren't allowed to have a campfire. They're just gonna make fires, even if there's no fire ring. In my eyes, there's probably going to be a lot of wildfires this year, human caused, of course, because of that, because people aren't going to have the campgrounds to go to that they usually go to. Obviously, there are so many people that are well versed in dispersed camping and know how to do it safely and clean up their trash and all of that, but there are so many people that have used campgrounds for generations who are now going to be like, well, let's just take the truck and the trailer and go out the middle fork and go camping anyway on one of those little side pull-offs. There are so many beautiful dispersed camping areas. However, they are not equipped for making fires, and my guess is there's going to be a lot of trash and human feces left in those areas, unfortunately. So it is a very huge concern, and I would love to hear the reasoning behind them keeping stuff closed. I think that is the most frustrating part, is that they're not giving us reasons. They're just saying, oh, it's closed till who knows when, foreseeable future, whatever, and you guys just have to deal with it. I think that's the most frustrating part of all this, is we're not given a reason. At this point, Washington State Parks are reopening this week. California has reopened places. It just makes no sense. And we had some of the lowest case numbers here in Oregon, and it just is mind-boggling, to be honest. So yeah, it's a huge concern. Okay, Kira from Facebook said, "Things that I have experienced out on the trails that I can walk to near my home in Bend. For the most part, all hikers and people walking are great about moving off the trail in order to stay 6 feet apart when passing. Runners, on the other hand, run up behind me and pass within inches of me and don't say a word. As soon as I know they are there, I scramble to move out of the way, but I can't get far enough away. It is so frustrating. It is also a bummer to have to worry about it. Being out on the trail with my dog has been one of the best things during these strange times. Wow, yeah, I have not experienced that just because I haven't gone to any trails where there's other people. But I imagine that near Bend, obviously, the trails that are close to town within walking distance are gonna have quite a few people. And that's so great to hear that people are being kind and courteous and staying away. And that's really unfortunate that people who are running aren't really adhering to that. I think there was a study about how 6 feet, especially when you're recreating, especially running and sweating, is not gonna be enough because, you know, someone's sweat or spit or bodily fluids could very easily land on you, especially if they're like this close to you. Study has shown that 6 feet actually when you're recreating is not enough. Joy Poulin from Instagram said, "We are dying to get back to the beach and hiking, but nervous about going back into heavily populated areas, not knowing if someone could have no symptoms and be a carrier." Yes, I think people are going to be nervous for a very long time. I think that's just what we're gonna have to live with. And we're just going to have to accept that eventually we will come in contact with someone who has it, or if it's on a surface or something. And that's unavoidable at this point. We cannot live in seclusion forever. Obviously, that is in the long run actually going to be really detrimental because we have to build herd immunity eventually, right? I know we wanted to flatten the curve to protect our healthcare system, which totally makes sense, but eventually we all need herd immunity. Otherwise, we're going to be in the exact same spot come late fall, early winter again. Yeah, it's definitely a worry, but there are places to go where you can avoid people, especially as trails open up more and people aren't congregating in these very specific areas. Melissa from Facebook said, "How can those of us with only one night available and limited to car or short walk get out there? For a day hike, how can we abide by the no parking at trailheads order yet get out for socially distant day hike within our area?" Because Oregon still has the stay-at-home order, so don't travel unless it's essential, people are obviously adhering to that and are wondering how they can get out. And that's a good question. If you don't live in Bend, I mean, there are hiking trails literally within walking distance of the town of Bend, which is so amazing. In Eugene, there are a few as well. There are a few nature parks in Salem that I've seen people walk at. Unfortunately, Corvallis closed their nearby recreation area. I'm not sure about Corvallis. Portland still has parks open as well that are in the city. So there are things available within walking distance or, you know, a very short drive. So her question about the parking at the trailhead refers to, here in Oregon, like I said before, the developed trailheads. So the trailheads with facilities are technically closed, but they didn't close the forest technically, so you can still hike there, I guess, but you're not supposed to park in the parking lot because a lot of the time they're blocked off. Just avoid those trails, just pretend they're closed completely. Trying to park along the side of a road or on another road that may block someone's access to something is just not a good idea. I've heard of a lot of people getting towed and stuff like that, so just avoid those trails. There are so many undeveloped trailheads that you can go hike, where you can park directly at the trailhead and not inconvenience anybody or have to park on the side of a busy highway, which is dangerous. Leslie from Facebook said, "I have noticed while hiking the trails that are still open, people have become unfriendly, turning their heads and avoiding eye contact, no smiles or hellos. There used to be comradeship of people sharing trails. Come on, people, smiling is contagious, and that's not a bad thing." This is so true. Smiling is not contagious. And like Kira said before, just moving 6 feet off the trail, being kind and courteous, I don't know why people can't do that. It's unfortunate. I've noticed the same sort of kind of unfriendly behavior in grocery stores. I really attribute it to people are scared. If they see another person, they're like, oh my God, another person. And what if they're too close? And they freak out, right? They're freaking out in their heads. So just think of them as like, they're probably scared and that's why they're exhibiting this behavior. Maybe just take it upon yourself to make the first move, step off the trail, the 6 foot distance, smile, say hi, it's a beautiful day out, blah, 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 right? Katie Sakosi from Instagram said, I believe that there are way too many people everywhere and unfortunately we have to put limits on the crowds. Nature will not put up with our damaging her lands, water, and air. It's a gift to be alive and to be human. Let's all take a moment and realize nature is much bigger than us, and hopefully we all have learned something from this moment in our lives. Let's love our world and the people and animals in it. Yes, I think we all have learned something very important from this whole pandemic, as it has brought out the ugliest of ugly. It has also made things really beautiful. Like in Venice, the canals were running clear. There was dolphins and fish for the first time in so long. And the air pollution all around the world has completely dropped, which is so amazing. Just in the last 2 months, there's been so much good that has come out of this. And I think that as much as we are in our heads and how it's depressing and very negative, we also have to look at the good that has come from this. And last but not least, Jason from over at P&W Adventures and Gear Reviews said,
my concern with the COVID pandemic thing would be them keeping us in lockdown way too long, causing problems with summer plans.
So summer recreation, that terrifies me to no end. You have no idea how scared I am for our state here in Oregon. The fact that we are not opening anything up for the foreseeable future is going to be super detrimental to the tourism industry. Like I said, Washington is opening stuff up this week. California is opening stuff up. Idaho, I believe, is opening stuff up. So our surrounding neighbors are all opening things up. Once people feel safe to travel again, they're going to go to those states. They're not going to come to Oregon because their campground reservations were canceled, and they're going to go elsewhere. They're going to go to Washington, beautiful state, lots of hiking, lots of outdoor recreation. They're going to go to Idaho, tons of beautiful outdoor recreation. They're going to go to Northern California. I'm scared that Oregon is just going to kind of fall to the wayside, and it's going to be a huge hit to the outdoor industry, all the industries that go along with that, you know, the restaurant industry, the hotel industry, all of that, if tourists don't come to Oregon this summer. And yes, there are people that are still gonna travel this summer. Not everyone has lost their jobs. Not everyone is absolutely broke. And those people are still gonna travel, and they're just not gonna come to Oregon. And it's really scary. As far as your summer recreation plans, I would probably just change them a little bit. Like I said, even if the developed trailheads and campgrounds do remain closed, the more we get into summer and the more the snow melts, more and more undeveloped trailheads will become accessible. And there are so many options that we can still go explore. So don't lose hope just yet. We can still go backpacking. We can still go recreate. It will just have to look a little bit different. I know many of us had campground plans, family plans. Those are all gonna have to change, unfortunately. We'll just have to revise them. So if you are interested in finding out what trails are available and open for hiking, just check out my website, hikeoregon.net. I always update stuff on there, and every week I have been putting up 2 to 3 brand new hike write-ups. So once people feel safe to travel again, that's going to be a huge resource for everybody. I would love to hear down in the comments below how you are handling all of this and if your state is starting to open up certain businesses. Thank you so much for joining me on this 3-part pandemic hiking 101 series. I sincerely hope that I don't have to make a part 4 of this video series and that we can all start getting back to semi-normal sometime soon. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you on the next adventure.